It's Tuesday, July 23rd, 2019, and today I'm on page 188 of The God of Small Things. A gauze door creaked, and an airport fairy with horn bumps and yellow-rimmed red plastic sunglasses looked in with the sun behind her. The factory was angry-colored. The salted limes were red. The tender mangoes were red. The label cover was red. The dusty sunbeam that Osa never used was red. The gauze door closed. Rahel stood in the empty factory with her fountain in 11 Tokyo. She heard a nun's voice singing the boat song, a clear soprano wafting over vinegar fumes and pickle vats. She turned to Esta, bent over the scarlet broth in the black cauldron. "What do you want?" Esta asked without looking up. "Nothing," Rahel said. "Then why have you come here?" Rahel didn't reply. There was a brief, hostile silence. "Why are you rowing the jam?" Rahel asked. "India's a free country," Esta said. No one could argue with that. India was a free country. You could make salt, row jam if you wanted to. The orange drink, lemon drink man could just walk in through the gauze doors, if you wanted to. And Amu would offer him pineapple juice, with ice. Rahel sat on the edge of a cement vat, frothy ends of buckram and lace delicately dipped in tender mango pickle, and tried on the rubber finger guards. Three blue bottles fiercely fought the gauze doors, wanting to be let in, and Osa the barn owl watched the pickle-smelling silence that lay between the twins like a bruise. "What are you reading today?"